Hey folks, it's Brian, and it's time for another episode of my F-350 rescue project. So, tonight, I got my 15/32 inch drill bit. I'll put a link in the video description for this. It was kind of hard to find. And then I've got my switch. And, you know, when we push the switch, nothing happens with the ignition turned off. But I'm going to mount the switch here. So first thing I want to do is just verify. Oh yeah, plenty of space. In fact, I could probably come up to right there, so that's where I'm going to put it. So, let me get the camera mounted, then I'll drill a hole in the plastic. Sorry that's at an angle, guys. It just is what it is. About as good as it's gonna get. Now, I don't want the whole button sticking out. I think that's about right there. Now for my next trick. It doesn't fit. It's supposed to be 15/32. I do want it to be really, I don't want it sticking out very much. So. What's that? All get started. Okay, so I had intended to film starting it with a button, and I screwed up the camera because the sun was in my eyes. So anyway, I pulled the truck forward, I've washed it, now I'm going to put it back. So, I just sprayed a bunch of water on the engine, so it might behave, it might not, but here goes the button. So it's over here, that's my glow plugs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hey, they seem to work. Batteries even held the charge. That's exciting, considering that the alternator isn't worth shit. Anyway, let's back it up. There we go. Got some bricks or pieces of cement back there that I use as backup stops so I don't run into the fence. Anyway, as you can see, it runs, and we can pull it forward again. It's not going to hurt to move two or three times. Plenty of oomph. Can't wait to get this to the point where I can have it on the road. But there's a handful of things that need to happen. First, I don't have any power steering. And that's why I had to clean the engine, because the power steering pump's been leaking for a while. And so I'm going to replace the power steering pump, and then I'm going to do a 3G alternator upgrade. Those are my next couple projects. Probably change all the belts and hoses while I'm at it, because I've got to take a bunch of crap apart to get in there. And then I should be able to get to the running lights and some creature comfort things like the wipers and the door or the window and door lock mechanisms. So whoever had this before has no business touching wire, pliers, or wrenches, because they screwed up a bunch of shit in here. But I'll get it back together. Thanks for watching. Hope you found this fun.